Please, hi, hi.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Please take it, sir.
Salam. You are comfortable?
Yes, sir.
When is your entry, Osama?
24th.
24th. This is the first time you are coming to Opti?
Yes.
Okay. And tell us something about yourself, Suman.
So my name is Suman Ghosh. I am from Cuttack.
Yes.
I completed my schooling from Medinsa College at School Cuttack. I completed my plus two from Medinsa Junior College Cuttack. I have done my graduation from College of Agriculture, IIT Bhubaneswar. Currently I am pursuing my master's in Department of Genetics and Plant Breeding, College of Agriculture, IIT Bhubaneswar.
Awarded 2 times by Honorable CM for district level audio debate competition, selected as best intern for all days under KEUS. Yes. Tell us something about this KEUS. What is KEUS?
Sir, during my fourth year in college, there is a program called KEUS Krishi Unnata Sahayogi program.
Okay.
In which you have to, the RAWE student, you have to do ground level work in the village under the RAWE program, rural agricultural work experience program, where you have to work various work like e-pest surveillance. You have to work with the farmers about the farm pond, Kalia Yojana, Balaram Yojana, and they will survey the how much you have worked in weekly basis. After 3 months, they give a review in which I get the best intern in Odisha.
Excellent. Now that Suman, you have the you are an expert. I mean, you're a scholar in agriculture, genetics, and plant breeding, and also you had a lot of exposure at the field level, and best intern also. So we can say you have theory as well as practice.
Yes.
So on the agricultural front, on the agricultural scenario, when you became a civil servant, development administrator, including agriculture. So you will be going to the field with a lot of ideas brimming in your head,
yes.
Isn't it?
Yes.
So let us say when you become to begin with the BDO or Tahsildar to begin with, and you are given a area, a taluk, what are going to be your priorities?
So the first priority, I will say that how the soil condition of my area, how the production and productivity of my area, what the crops they are growing, and what is the quality of the product they are growing. If they are doing something value addition they are doing or what. And I will also look at the diversification program they are doing. And I will also look at the irrigation facilities, what are available in my area, and the fertilizer they are taking, and also the mandi system or what the market structure there, the cold storage facility available or not. And after surveying all the things, I will look up at the matter and I will implement the programs like difference program government is giving, but people are not aware of the programs. I will and the KBK is also giving lot of training program, but they are not aware of it. I will try them to make them aware of the things, and I will try it so that they can implement that things.
Wonderful, Suman. Coming to the administration, one of the areas which is afflicting India is corruption.
Yes,
corruption is an issue.
Yes,
it's a governance issue, it's an administrative issue. But thinking about corruption, individual corruption, institutional corruption, systemic corruption, where do you think that corruption is in India and Odisha? Is it arrested at the individual level or institutional level or systemic level?
Sir, according to me, it is at both, it is at all the levels.
All the levels.
Yes,
Tahale, Deru. Very good. I think we have shed our hypocrisy. In other words, we are saying the system is corrupt. No system is free of corruption. In other words, which would include, with due respect, the judiciary also, I presume. Okay.
Yes.
When you say systemic,
yes,
it is part of the system.
Yes.
Okay. In which case, how do we address? It's a big topic, but very briefly. If the corruption has penetrated institutions have corrupted the systems. It's a very serious governance issue.
Yes,
so how do we address it? Okay, to come to the point, do you think there is a need for electoral reforms?
Yes, sir. So the election system here, there is a people or politicians are using the buying the vote banks, or they are using the petroleum system. They are using the people like currently the West Bengal election, Panchayat election.
Yeah.
They are attacking the person. They are doing the criminalization of the politics. Happen. They have to vote the people. The left three number, they have to vote them, otherwise they are attacking them outside. I think it's a criminalization of the politics and the election system.
Okay, you are taking us to another area, and you have, since you have come to that. Okay, this criminalization of politics, politicians themselves are criminals. I mean,
yes, sir.
Academically, without any disrespect to. There was a WARA committee report, and then the criminals were being used by politicians at one stage. Criminals themselves entered politics.
Yes.
It's a huge issue. But why the system is not tackling it? Do you think the criminal justice system has broken down, has collapsed, or it has become dysfunctional? Because today we are told many of the MPs, a good percentage of MPs have criminal records, but there is no conclusion of the criminal justice system. Cases are pending.
Yes, sir.
We hear yes, but no conviction. So a lot of problems is there, isn't it?
Yes.
And anyway, to come back to the point, electoral reforms, do you think state funding of the election will be a solution? Because fighting elections, running your campaigns, you need a lot of funds, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
And funds are collected in a non-transparent manner.
Yes.
To bring about transparency, what should we do?
Sir, yes, a state election is a good idea. I can do it by election. The state election commission can do it.
Okay. On the same subject, one last question, and then I am done, and our honorable members will take over. When you become, let us say, collector of a district at some point in due course, how do you address this issue of corruption?
Sir, if I find corruption in my office, first I will do a...
Not in your office only, you have to do
something. If someone complains about the corruption happening, first I will survey about the corruption is happening. I will take all the matters into my consideration and survey first. I will not question him first that it is happening or not. After getting all the, if I get some point that it is happening, if I get into something, then I will ask him what, why this corruption is happening. And after that I will send him notice that give me the reason why this is happening. If this is not stopped, then I will take actions. I will send it to the other officers, higher officers.
Okay. So.
Okay. You have been taking home science and then agriculture.
Yes.
So after green revolution, we had many other revolutions like white revolution, pink revolution, blue revolution. Can you tell us about those and highlight on those?
So there is a yellow revolution. It is about oil seeds. But then there is a pink revolution. It is about meat and also about onion. There is a sweet revolution. It is for the horticultural crops. Currently we are following evergreen revolution, which is the following crop diversification and all aspects of crop. We also follow the blue revolution. It is for the fishery sector. And after the yellow revolution, oil seed production has already increased due to the technology implementation in 1980s. But currently India is again dependent upon import for the oil seed production.
Yes. Why?
Because of the increase in the population, we cannot produce that much amount of oil seed as a rate the population is increasing.
We are not self-sufficient in oil seeds.
Good.
And what are the other crops in which we are not self-sufficient? Major crop.
So fruits and vegetable horticultural crop, we are not self-sufficient. We are self-sufficient in pulse production and rice production, cereal production. But the other crop production, we are not, so that means
potato? Potato?
No, sir, we are not self-sufficient.
We are also doing grubs from outside.
Yes.
So can you tell us something about the immunization cycle for a child? So I will have to bath.
Yes, sir.
What are the different stages of different type of MRIs?
Sir, I don't know the exact date, but I know that the diphtheria vaccine, polio vaccine itself given, the mission under the is also implemented for the immunization program.
Mm, yes, very much. What do you know the any
of those? I don't know the exact
names also, you know? DPT.
Yes, sir.
Polio.
Polio, yes, sir.
And then?
Tetanus virus.
For smallpox, chickenpox.
Yes,
yes. What is the BCG?
BCG.
So like there are quite a few.
Yes.
That is related to our child health.
Yes.
So you have to let home science is your subject. So you belong to which district? Cuttack. So the Raven Sagar is at school. Yes. Is known for Subhash Chandra
Bose.
Bose.
Yes, sir.
Can you tell some of his times of school times of Subhash Chandra Bose? How he was?
School times?
Yes. Because after that he has no more there in Odisha. He has gone out.
Sir, he is from the Odia Bajar, Janaki Bose Bhavan Jota Ibe, Anand Bhavan, and there is again, after that he is studying in the Stuart Science School. Then he came to Ravensa Collegiate School, in which in our hostel also, in our school hostel also, there is a room separately for him. Till now it is kept as a museum for him. And he is the, then he go to, then he is the first one who joined civil service.
Luminaries of Cuttack district. Luminaries.
Utkalagora Matsudan Das, Ramakrishna Parija.
Tell the attributions also.
Utkalagora Matsudan Das, the Madhu barrister, the first person from Odisha who get the law degree.
Quickly, sit to another one. Then,
Varnavira Gaurishankar Rai, who is the person first as Utkala Deepika, the newspaper. Then, Rama Devi, she is the freedom fighter, he is also the Iron Lady. She is the freedom fighter and also joined the Gandhiji Satyagraha, Labani Satyagraha. Nandini Satpathy, who is called as the Lord of Manabhi Iron Woman. Mm-hmm. Then, Parry Mohan, who established the Parry Mohan Academy. And also the apparently the Kartar Singh Sarabhad, who is the part of the Gadar Mumbai, he is also from our school and he is part of the Cuttack, he is studying in Cuttack. Then Pranagushta Parija, the eminent scientist, the botanist, who is the principal of Ravensa University and the first dean of Utkal University. It is for the development, all around development of the
country. To improve enrollment and retention of girl students in the school.
Yes.
Because they will be dropouts after some time.
Yes.
It may so happen. So retention part is there. Enrollment first, then retention. Then what is Uttham?
So that is a scheme for the development of the
students of class 6 to 8.
Uttham.
And Utkarsh.
It is also for the
improve the secondary education system.
Okay, Uttham.
From class 9 to 10. Okay. Then what is the income of the BPL category people? Rural and urban. For rural it is 40,000, for urban it is 60,000. Then who is Kanta Kavi?
Kanta Kavi Lakshmi Kant
Mahapatra. Who is Jatiya Kavi? he belongs to Cuttack. He left his name. Is Birakeshwar Das?
Yes, sir.
Achha. Who is Malati Devi?
The Rama Devi and Malati Devi both are struggling in the South Satyagraha.
Malati Devi is wife of a chief minister. Who is he?
Gopala Krishna Chaudhary. I don't know, sir.
Navakushti Chaudhary.
Yes, sir.
And the husband of Rama Devi?
Gopalanda Chaudhary.
Gopalanda Chaudhary. Achha. Okay. And the daughter of Rama Devi was also a freedom fighter.
Annapurna
Maharani. Achha. There is a Swaraj Ashram.
Yes.
Why it is famous?
So the Mahatma Gandhi stayed there during
stay
the
there.
The Kathmandu, he gave a speech in Kathmandu before that. He would stay there.
All the activities relating to freedom movement, this civil disobedience movement, South Satyagraha, everything was going on there.
So,
then why Kavichandra Kalicharan Patnaik is famous? In which field?
Kavichandra is poet, but I don't know the name of the poet.
He has established Odisha theatres, and also he is a poet and a lyricist, and his autobiography, for his autobiography, he has been awarded Sahitya Academy Puraskar. What is the autobiography? Do you know? Kumbhar Chakra. Who is the first recipient of Gyanpith Award in Odisha?
Dr. Gopinath.
Good. So, how do you feel, Suman?
Sir, I need a lot of improvement.
No.
A lot of improvement.
No. No, these questions are inspirational. Okay, you know the answers. Some of the questions you would not know. That is a given. So we feel that you are excellent. Okay, and you are still a student at a very young age. You have made it, and your subjects are your own specialist subjects: agriculture and
home science.
Okay, so you have answered. You have depth enough, depth with. Sarandra question to pinning you down to Orissa, because the idea is Indian history, freedom struggle, and Orissa history, freedom struggle are part of it, integral part. We should know about it not for any other purpose, but to feel inspired, proud.
Yes.
See those ladies in those days,
yes,
going to jail and that. So it's an inspirational thing.
Yes.
So when you say that I have a lot of area to develop, nothing to do. You are very strong, very confident, you are at ease. But now we start, see, I mean, you are smiling now. You should smile in the course of it.
Yes.
No, any questions from your side? Suman, we are stopping here,
yes,
because not necessary. We don't need. Any questions from your side, Suman?
Sir, I don't know. I mean, I'm telling it or fumbling it, if there is a problem.
No, you are very comfortable. We like the way, even that. Subhash Chandra Bose got a room, even now it is preserved and it is news to me, at least to me.
Yes.
Sartha Janitha, etc. So good, I mean, you have interest. You are very happy about it, you are proud.
Yes.
This, some things you may not, factual things you may not know, don't worry about it. Dr. Gopinath Mohanty, you know that he was the first. Only Mr. So you know broadly all those things.
Yes, sir, I studied only the broader thing.
Naturally, because you are young.
Yes.
Because we are senior people, we know a little more about certain things, that's all. Okay, if you have no more questions, we are leaving you now, Suman.
Yes, sir.
Thank
you.
You are making it. All the best.
Thank you,
okay,
sir.
God bless you.
God bless you.
Thank you.
God bless.